Hello, this is your brother Gideon. Welcome to KFG. So, on the 23rd of April, 2020, Avram Ben-Moshe, leader of the Common Sense Family Movement in Ghana, posted a question and answer video on his YouTube channel. This was taken from his Facebook page. In this video, he gave opportunity to his viewers to call in and ask questions in relation to his teachings. One of the interesting questions that came in is what we are looking at today. The question was, how do we serve God if He exists and we are not supposed to do it the Christian or the Muslim way? Look at the answers He gave. Watch it yourself.
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, Bacho, we didn't have your Kasafi. And no question.
Bacho, I feel you have a Kasafi Kutubabi.
Yo, it's you.
Avram, me do a chica crana. My question, I'm basically going to be sorry. Two questions, Mumbai, it conjoins together. One, I can see, I've been hearing say you believe in God. I've been following you, you believe in God, but you don't believe in the fallacies of Christians. So as a follower of you, know, if truly there is God and that we shouldn't believe in the story of Jesus, how do you worship the God which maybe you believe there is a God? How, like, why am I saying the first question is I'm going to
Okay. And no, there be a mechanical platform is to say, yeah, no one cry womb, Zoe and Yomono. Yam may be as I say about Sumanyami, Yamanian to be in Sumano, own to be in Sumanyami, or no Yameno, or no Yamen woman, what boy, and what may all the resources we need. Yam to me, Pra, Yanko Pon them, yam to me, Sin in Yama, Yanko Pon, Undi D, Yanko Nabia Yaman, Yanko Pon, Yisika, O Yan Gold, O Yan Timba, O Yanwe. Enti oboye se yen sum ye ho we should serve ourselves tinye ka se tina bible na se di wager any winani wow anti we ni die bia ye de ma ye ho na ye serve ye ho serve ye ho no na ye de bu baby ye de ka se service to mankind is service to God untumi nya hwe ma nyame won ti se nyame bi oho a ye nti le kasa ye nim no ye hu ne da ye ni bebi otipo ni akosi ni amaman but de bia ye ti ne ho asim nyina no eye enhoma mu any in religion religion bia wo different concept of that God esu nkrimo for de esu hinda for de esu buddha for de esu christo for de christianity mu kura no esu pentecost esu methodist esu anglican esu sda obia ni gidie nti nyame asem no eno ne de wan nti yemfa that concept na nto nche into the other way, I say, oh, yeah, lawyer, no credit, justice, truthfulness, now what serve a picture, Aji, or more, or more man, Yemo, oh, yeah, police near Usumnipa, oh, yeah, president here, Usumnipa, oh, yeah, lawyer, Usumnipa, oh, yeah, judge here, Usumnipa, oh, yeah, comedian, Usumnipa, oh, yeah, footballer, Usumnipa, oh, yeah, coach, Usumnipa, oh, to Adriani, Usumnipa, ain't he? Yea, obey a dear me, a dear men nipano. Now, oh, why did you wire near Joe? Asa,
after watching this video, I wish I was live with them on that encounter so I could ask these questions. These questions came up in my heart, and I believe if you are a CSF member, you should also want to know the answers to these questions. Number one, how did Abraham know that God's purpose for creating us is so we serve one another? Yes, he says there is God and that his purpose is so that we serve one another. How did he come by that knowledge? Number two, what about those who are not willing to save humanity? What is the consequences for living to destroy humanity? For example, like the armed robber who is killing people, taking their properties. What is the consequence? Is there judgment for them? I wanted to know, honestly, the answer to this question. Will he be able to provide us answers? Number three, why does he quote from the Bible to support his claim on we serving one another? He quoted Ephesians 6 verse 2 to honor parents, but forgets that the Bible says we should worship God in spirit and in truth. Why doesn't he also use those verses which says we can worship God, but quote the one that says we should honor people, but forgets about the one that says we should worship God? Number four, how does he know we don't hear from God and don't know him? The Bible he quotes has records of people talking to God and God talking to men many times. The reason we can ask this question is because he quoted from the Bible. So if you can quote some portions of the Bible, why doesn't he also agree that God talks to people but goes ahead to say that God doesn't talk to anybody? If he exists, we don't know. The fifth question I want to ask him is this: does the singleness of opinion on a matter determine its authenticity? And does the divergence of opinion concerning a matter mean there is no truth about that matter? This is because he says there are different religions saying different things. And so because of that, we don't know the truth. We can't know the truth. We don't know which one to follow. Does it mean that concerning any matter, when there are divergent of opinions, there will be no truth? The sixth question that came to my heart is this, and you should seek to know the answer. Why does he believe God created us, but doesn't he believe that that intelligent creator can intelligently communicate with us? And number seven, if all we are here to do is to serve humanity, then there's no need for common sense family. What does he think? Because all religions in the world teach that people should be good, the members should be good. So if all he is teaching is that we should serve people and be good, then what is the place of common sense family today? Now let me show you why you need Jesus if you don't have Jesus already in six steps. Number one, in the history of man, God made man to fellowship with him and to take care of the earth. You will see that in Genesis chapter 2 verse 15. The Bible says, and the Lord God took the man and put him into the Garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it. So you see that man was given a work to be responsible for the earth. And in Genesis chapter 3 8, verse 8, we see God coming into the garden in the cool of the day for fellowship. Step 2, man allowed sin into the world by going against the word of God. He listened to the devil and became a slave to the devil and sin. And from that time, started living under the burden of sin and the devil. You see that in Romans 6, 16. The Bible says, know ye not, to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are, to whom you obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. So the moment man disobeyed God and listened to the devil, he became a servant of the devil. And Satan ruled man until Jesus came. Third step. Because of this fall of man, man continued in sin. Sin totally dominated man, so that the good man wanted to do, he's not able to do it, and the bad he doesn't want to do, that's what he always finds himself wallowing in. And many people living today can attest to that. They have many good intentions, but they are not able to do it. They have very good plans to do good. They don't want to lie, they don't want to steal, but some way, somewhere, they seem to have that sin coming against them. In Romans 3:23, the Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Man is not able to live as God wants him to live. Try as he may, he still fails. So the step four I want to show you, that God sent his son to ransom man from this predicament. Jesus Christ came to take the place of man. He came to die for man, to give his life to man, so that man can be restored to a living relationship with God and receive life from God in order to live the life God wants him to live. We see that in John 1:12. The Bible says, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So the moment you receive Jesus Christ, you receive life. You become a child of God. Then you have the energy to do the good you are supposed to do, and the energy to stop the bad you don't want to do. So if you want to do good to humanity, you are able to do it. Sin no longer dominates you. Step five, this life from Jesus Christ enables man to fellowship with God and to live a selfless life. Jesus Christ being our example. In Christianity, Jesus lived a selfless life and died for man, to restore man to a relationship with God, and also to set an example for man not to live for himself, but to live for the betterment of the world. So in Christianity, selfishness is never a virtue. Selfishness is never allowed. Anybody who is coming to Christ, who is being raised in the truth, knows that they are supposed to live for God and to live to help the world come to a better place. Now, this takes me to the sixth step. When you come into Christ, step six says you have a purpose, you have an assignment in Christ. Colossians 4:17 says, "Say unto Archippus, take heed to the ministry which you have received in the Lord, that you fulfill it." The moment you believe in Jesus Christ and you find yourself in the light, there is an assignment for your life which God has given to you, and you begin to now discover it and to follow it and to do it. That is the purpose for your life. It is only in Christ. So anybody who is outside of Christ doesn't realize their purpose. It is until you come into Christ, then you realize your purpose and you begin to live it out. Now, it is on the basis of what God has called us for, that purpose, that He is going to judge us. So when we stand before Him, He's going to ask us, "I asked you to do A, B, C, D. As you came into me, I led you and I showed you by my spirit. What did you do amongst these things that I told you?" Then if you did all, or you did what He asked you to do, you have reward from Him. But then if you live selfishly, then you are going to lose your reward. But then, because you believe in Jesus Christ, you are saved. Hallelujah. This is why you need Jesus Christ today. This is beyond religion. This is beyond common sense. This is what God is doing in this time. Hallelujah. Think about it. Ponder on it. And let's see what you come up with. God bless you. I am your brother, Gideon Boateng, and I'm bringing you the word of God live from the Upper West region of Ghana. If you are new on this channel, kindly consider subscribing as well as turning on the bell for notification. I'll see you in the next video. God bless you. Bye.